lumberjack.
Maybe a little simpler.
Scrunchy.
What?
Scrunchy.
All right, scrunchy.
Yeah. I miss it.
You miss it. It had such important memories, and I got it from my mother, actually.
Yeah, no, I remember when she gave it to you, there was like that ceremony.
It was our wedding. Yeah. I don't know how much you remember of that day, given the alcohol intake.
Yeah, the reception's a bit blurred.
The scrunchie, though, seems to be what you hold on to the most.
Yeah, you really look beautiful with that white veil and this, hot pink scrunchie.
It all together. It was a lovely day.
So we had this brilliant idea for the business.
I know it sounds weird, but a scrunchie-themed restaurant. We had a blown-out first-week sales. People were coming in and out, coming with the scrunchie, without the scrunchie. We provided scrunchies. I mean, it was great. We're up at Zagat or whatever the restaurant, that restaurant magazine is.
Yeah, the main requirement was that every girl who comes in, if she had long hair, you have to put the scrunchie at the door.
Right, and some people, they come in with the short hair, but we just give them wigs, and then it's amazing, actually, the kind of customer, the clientele we're getting at this place.
I mean, there were some old people, and even 14-year-olds, some couples.
Babies.
Restaurant where it was a scrunchy thing.
That's your mom, I tell you.
I mean, come on now. I mean, it doesn't take much to see that I can't.
Well, they have the furry ones. The little restaurant, they give you the wig. You can attach them and really?
But come on. I mean, he just wasn't thinking. He was cute though.
He was cute. Well,
yeah, he was really cute.
Maybe he thought you would look good in a hot pink wig.
Yeah. Yeah. made for some good entertainment later. The way we got the music.
Cuba.
Yeah, right? It's so awesome. I'm so excited. It's the first vacation we've been on in years.
Oh, it's going to be wonderful. I used to smuggle Cuban cigars, but now I can actually buy them. I heard you can actually buy the Cubans, too. They make $25 a month, so you can get half a dozen of them.
Perfect! I thought this was just a vacation, and now it's a business, trip for you. Always, it's like this. Yeah. Tell me, it's fun.
I'm a housekeeper, a Cuban lawman.
Okay, if we're bringing home any Cubans, I do want a housekeeper. This house is simply too large to dust. I can't handle the 7 bathrooms.
But you live in 4 of them.
That's why I can't handle 7. I don't like that all of them are mine.
Well, let's see. I think we're going to bring home all kinds of Cubans.
That polka dot scrunchie you're making is beautiful. Do you want some dazzle?
Absolutely, yeah. Yeah, I want her to look great for this.
I mean, it looks beautiful and it's going to match your dress amazingly.
Absolutely, yeah.
We girls don't have a chance.
But they never let me express myself. I look great in scrunchies.
They're so conscious, they're just not comfortable with their scrunchiness. You need to show them what they're.
you know that you were a scrunchie gal?
Well, I'm now a dummy girl, a dummy book. Dummies for scrunchies.
Understand, you know, when I tell her something, like maybe they need to have a class for how you should talk to your hairdresser.
Has she tried scrunchies?
She tried. It was just like one big headband.
No conversation about hot pink extensions to go with it. Like, what kind of hairdresser?
Did they offer a wig?
No. I don't know what to tell her anymore. You know, when I say Cliff, you know, she's like shave when I we're like this now.
It might be time for a new hairdresser.
I think so.
Actually, think so. There's this great restaurant that just opened up. They specialize in exactly what you're looking for.
Crunchy
hair. At the door.
Come on.
Oh yeah.
But how do they incorporate that with the food?
You know, that's not something we really want to talk about.
Okay.
Oh my god, it took us so long to get in. Yeah. Finally, we're in this restaurant.
It's like scrunchy
heaven. I hope they serve Cuban cigars in there.
So how are you guys? You've been here. Actually, Mr. Brown, you've been here several times. How are you doing?
Never. Yes, I'm very fine.
You know, one thing I love about him is the tips. I mean, I love his personality. He's a very good-looking man, but the tips are what I come for. You know, the first time he came in here, he ordered a coffee, and then he dropped a $20 bill as a tip. It was amazing. The week after, he ordered a couple of rolls. $200 tip. The third week, he left a treasure map. I'm a millionaire now. I'm not even sure why I'm a waiter. I guess I just enjoy the work.
The only tips in this restaurant, by the way, I've been with him in other restaurants, and he's not as generous there.
Well, it's the service, really, and it's the vein. I'm like, I just date scrunchies.
I will be right back with your drinks.
Did you really think that leaving breadcrumbs was going to get us out of the forest? Seriously? Really?
Well, I'd like to have something to clean up.
We moved up. I don't want to go to the suburbs. In Georgetown, there was no forest. There's moss
out
there.
Never any trees. They chop them all down.
So how do you know? Now there's a lawn and there are trees and all kinds of squirrels. I'm scared to death living
here. Squirrels are scary, and they're all, what's the word, they're like civilized. They come up to you and they steal the thing.
This is nuts that we moved here.
Suburbs, I tell you. Next we're going to get a minivan, the squirrels are just going to follow us along. I hate to say it though, I'm a little upset that you took my rye bread and cheese. That was for dinner, that was for the guests.
Well,
now that we're in the suburbs, we have to have like cocktail parties and
posters. Right, well, Ryan,
we. You again.
You took my scrunchie. I know you did.
You left that scrunchie in my house for longer than a 90-day period without coming to get it, and it's therefore mine.
Because you stole it off of my head while
you
I was sleeping.
Did not come to get it.
I really don't know why I'm so friends with you.
Well, I mean, it's probably because you take all of my lipstick. Just saying.
Well, you left it at my house for at least the 30-day window, and that is the rule for lipstick.
There is a lipstick subclause.
Absolutely. Mascara, 1 week. Lipstick, 1 month.
Blush. hard 3 years.
Well, thank God I don't follow that rule.
doing really well. What do you think?
Yeah.
I've been getting a lot more Tinder dates, and I think it all has to do with what I'm eating.
That's probably right. I mean, do you eat on the dates? You have like your diet?
Yeah, I mean, I try to only eat before the date. Like, I'll just have like a big bowl of avocados and water, and I'll just go on the date. But, you know, I think you should try it since you've been having so much trouble on OkCupid, right?
Yeah, that's been really rough on me. But I'm pretty sure it's not because I need to lose weight. I mean,
yeah.
I mean, I don't think it's that.
Look, I can't argue with it, you know, but that date you went on with that guy last week and he was like really in the ears and stuff, like, I feel like you could up your quality a little.
Okay, well, who are you to judge? Like, ears are, I mean, you know, that's a cool
thing. Is that your thing too? Are you into that too?
It's not bad.
I mean, they say don't knock until you try it.
Yeah. But I mean, like, when you're out with these guys, like, what do you, so like, you eat before, but then like, what do you
No, eat? On the date, no eating. No. Absolutely.
But, like,
absolutely not. Yeah. Don't eat on a dinner date.
That must be where I'm going wrong.
That's my secret tip.
Oh my gosh.
Don't do it.
That's
yeah.
what I think.
It'll really throw them, and they'll just be like,
oh, so I know this might be really weird, but am I allowed to ask you to dance?
Why would you? Yeah, sure, whatever. all right, I'll go for it, I guess.
Okay, oh no, I mean, it's like...
Oh, okay.
I mean, like,
I don't think it's allowed.
I think
it's
illegal. No.
It is. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. No, but I've just had a crush on you, like, this cute week. What are you doing with my boyfriend?
It's a 1 week crush. It's
very
important.
No, I mean, it's not long. Usually it's just a few days.
I don't care if it's a few days or it's a few hours. He is my boyfriend. No.
Can we at least get some shooting lunch together?
So... I really think that we should talk about these 1 week crushes. I'm going a little far.
I mean, Brian was gorgeous. Did you blame me? And then there was Todd. Did you see the ass on there?
That was pretty great abs. I mean, that's besides the point. I just, you know, I'm thinking, you're just keeping these 1 week crushes. It's really intense. You're kind of getting in there.
I'm in love with them.
You're making love or you're in love? Different things. And we really need to zero in on what that
is. Like, you keep it in the bedroom?
Oh, okay. Okay. It's just, you know, I think it's a little inappropriate at school, you know, just maybe rein it in.
Okay, so like 2 weeks?
Okay, sweetie. Okay, just smile for the camera, okay? You're gonna look so great at prom. Hi, darling. Green is your color.
Okay.
Honk, honk.
Babe, let's go.
Okay.
You ready?
You're bringing your boyfriend to my prom.
I really want to see a family picture.
Peter is not my family. I'm wearing the green dress. I smiled for your photo. I don't want to talk to you, Peter.
We didn't want to say anything, but, you know, as a member of the PTA prom planning committee, we did decide to make the prom wedding themed for
your wedding.
No.
Don't you want to be there?
No! This cannot be happening. You're going to get married at my prom?
We just really needed a flower girl.
I mean, I can be a flower girl.
Is your mom getting married at our prom?
Like,
not received an invite yet.
Yes.
It must have been a mistake, right?
Definitely. You're new to the neighborhood. I do have your address.
Right.
So
I hear there's going to be a crazy theme this year, and I have a lot of ideas. I just wanted to like throw them out there and like get them coming. So one of my ideas is just like to do black, like just a black color everything.
Oh my God, honey, I've been looking for you forever. I've been waiting for so long to do this, so I'm sorry to interrupt our meeting, but I just had to do this now. Will you please spend the rest of my life with me?
Pretty good plans.
Yeah, it's all right, I guess. I mean, with all the shortages and salary.
I mean, I agree we can spare one wall in the rec center, but I think if we go any fewer walls than that, it's not a rec center anymore. It's just, it's like a cabana.
Exactly. Yeah, exactly. You know, the thing is, we don't get paid enough for this.
It's true. Especially with the shortages.
I know. It's just like, we don't have health care, we don't have food, we don't even have clean water.
Yeah, it's ridiculous.
And all for this, like,
more organisms in it than usual.
Yeah.
I'm not thinking that. Anyway, the boss is going to want us to start building this tomorrow, I think.
Oh, boy. Why does he have to short all of it? Like, everything. The wall, our salaries, our time to rest.
Well, he's dressed around in a 1991 Cadillac DeVille, like so. Hey, one more round of applause for the local Wi-Fi.
When I hear pizza, I think of DiGiorno, and when I think of DiGiorno, I think of home.
When I think of pizza, I think of cheese, which makes me think of French restaurants.
When I think of pizza, I also think of restaurants, and that makes me think of children's birthday parties. When I think of pizza, I think of baking, and when I think of baking, I think of France.
When I think of pizza, I think of pepperoni, and when I think of pepperoni, I think of people improperly patting their cod pieces.
I'm just trying to stuff this in before we go to the Halloween party. I just want to, you know, dressing up as a football player, so I want to be really big looking.
Yeah, you do want to be big looking. It's like you've gone to 3 or 4 Halloween parties, and I feel like you just get bigger and bigger with each costume.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, this one is the Hulk football player.
Nice.
I like what you've got going on there, a little bit of a Spider-Man look.
Yeah. You know, I like to just, you know, embody the spider as much as possible.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm thinking maybe what we should do is, you know, we've got some fresh fruits and vegetables. What do you think about adding those to what you've got in there?
Sure, what do you have in mind?
Well, how about a zucchini?
Okay.
It's green, so it goes with the Hulk.
Okay, yeah, there we go, perfect. So what do you think, nose?
I like it.
Okay.
That is good. That is embodying the Hulk.
Okay, so...
Okay, good. I think we can work in...
Hold it up as the nose there.
Well, no, we should either glue or tape it on.
Okay, can you help me?
We've got masking tape.
Okay, let's...
Excellent. All right, okay, this is coming together. We've got some Legos in back.
Legos?
Yeah, Legos. What do you think? We can add some Legos in?
Sure.
We would add some bulk, some flavor.
Okay, let's
yeah.
do it. Let's
okay.
do it.
All right.
You have the greatest costume ideas. That's, you know, I love going to Halloween parties with you.
Oh, thank you, man. I love going to Halloween parties with you, too. You just really, you know, it...
So I'm going on a date, and I want you to help me get dressed. What do you think I should wear?
You know, the neighbors dropped off their gerbil for us to pet it, and I think that would accessorize well with your sweater. So,
like
a gerbil.
That's my best friend. I'm trusting you here.
Okay, pet the gerbil.
Never let me down, so.
Never. I would not let you down. I see you with the gerbil. I see your date being like, dude, never been out with the guy who had a gerbil.
Like,
loving it. Wanting to jump in every place. You've got a gerbil.
Do I put this in my pocket?
No. You've got to feature the gerbil. Oh, embrace the gerbil. You've got to feel the gerbil.
Okay, so I'm going to my first job interview. I need you to help me get ready. What do you suggest I wear?
Okay, so I was taking hot air ballooning lesson, and it turns out you can actually just attach a hot air balloon to yourself and float.
No kidding.
I bet you no one floats in there. You are going to be under pressure, my friend. You can be the one who's got their head in the clouds, literally and figuratively, and they're going to like that. They're going to be like,
sounds a little dangerous.
So I have heard such good things about you, and I'm so excited that you're here to style me for my wedding tomorrow.
I could not be more excited that you are here to be styled for the wedding either.
So, what are you thinking?
Are you aware that there are parallel universes?
Yeah, I think it looks great, and, you know, I'm sure all the kids will be really happy. I think ever since you did the party with him where you brought all the kids and you set up the moon bounce and everything like that, they know that his party's gonna be the best.
Yeah,
so
do you think it's enough cake? You know, Timmy's a big boy.
You're right.
I have a sweet tooth that needs some cake.
You're right.
Mommy, I'm really hungry.
I told you he's a big boy.
Yes, yeah. I think what's needed is maybe some more things. Some cookies.
Or maybe two cakes?
Two cakes could be good.
I've got 10 minutes.
I think you should maybe whip one up.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
Why stop at two cakes? I think, in addition, we can even actually just bring a whole platter of 6-foot subs and just set them all up there. And it'll be great. We'll have all the food we need.
That sounds like a very good idea.
Mom, can I invite the hockey guys over?
He starts to play hockey last year. Isn't there like 15 guys on the stadium?
Yeah. You know, I guess we better. I guess we're just gonna need to get more. We're gonna need to get more food. All right, sure. Yeah, the hockey team can come. That's fine.
Yeah.
I got this giant this tub of ice cream here.
Okay.
I'm sure that'll probably add in.
I'm so glad you bought that earlier today.
Yep. I know exactly. You know. I actually just took a whole shopping cart from the. And I loaded it up with, popsicles and mega-size fruits.
Okay.
So, I think we're going to have everything we need.
Did someone call for a gravy truck?
Yes, I did. Yeah, I called just a couple hours ago. That's great.
Excellent. Just sign here. Do you want us to pull it around front or back?
Yeah, you've got the hose, right?
The nozzle.
See, we're getting everything we need.
So maybe we can get like some troughs from the backyard.
Yeah, and we'll just the kids, they can just kneel down and just slurp it into their mouth. I think they'll have everything they need.
Mommy, I'm having trouble getting out of bed.
See, this is happening more and more these days. You know, when we first came here, like, what was it, 3 months ago?
I think it was like 2 3/4 months.
2 3 months. I was just so honored that you picked me out of everyone in our wrestling class.
Well, you were just the most dynamic person in there. You could wrestle anybody to the ground in like 3 seconds flat.
Yeah, just pin them to the ground.
And that strength is always the thing that gets me.
I know. It brings back such fond memories.
I know, it's been such a long, wonderful beginning to a relationship.
Oh, yeah. So, are you excited for the game coming up?
Yes, I am thrilled for the game coming up. I can't wait to watch the tug of war competition.
I know.
It's that strength that just gets me. And then, like, tugged out, just really gets me excited.
Yeah, I can feel that.
Which I think will be a good benefit for you later.
I can't wait to calm down. Donkey Town.
See, that's the sort of thing. I don't need brains, I just want brawn.
All these muscles right here.
Oh.
So many. Well, I wake up every day, I walk leisurely to the bathroom. You're poor while you're doing it.
And you're poor.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
So great. Well, I'll flex each individual tooth. Right? Just like flossing. Get in there.
And that gets your fingers strong and your teeth get extra strong.
We're all gonna benefit from this. Get working on your catwalk.
Working on my catwalk.
You're gonna kill it tonight.
You think so?
Yep. Yeah, I know. I know you will. That dress is beautiful. You've always been such a good model.
And you've been the best modeling coach I've had since I started last week.
I have a knack for, you know, taking questionable cases and turning them into success.
And when you say questionable cases, you mean like question how great they're gonna be.
No. I mean, you were bad. You were really bad. And thanks to me, now you are great. So here, I'm gonna.
Wait, I'm great. So I'm great. We're in total agreement. I'm great.
I told you, you're gonna kill that there. Now, we're just gonna make one adjustment to your walk.
Okay.
There needs to be a little more hip.
Okay. More hip.
So it's a little flat. It feels a little flat. So you're just gonna. We need to crawl. There's a little bit of
awesome, right?
Really bad. Really bad.
Get down.
I think it needs a little more hip still. So let's bring it back. With the hip.
Okay.
Getting it. Yes, we're keeping going. Yes. Yes, there we go. Very nice.
All right.
Okay. Now, in addition, when you get up to the front, okay, there needs to be a hair move.
Okay. A hair move.
Yeah. You're gonna slick it back like that. Okay. So yeah, exactly. So I want to see it. I want the hips and the slick back hair. Let's go.
Okay. So it's hip and slick.
Yep.
Hip and slick.
Yes, you got it. Okay.
Don't get carried away.
Yeah, no spinning. Just the hips and slicking there.
No spinning.
No.
Okay. When you say no spinning, you mean like just a little bit of spinning, right? The spinning would be
no
cool.
Spinning. No spinning.
Okay. So just a little bit.
I think you're mishearing me. But let's have a go. Let's see.
Okay, so which end do you want me to start from?
Just keep coming. Keep coming back.
Okay.
Yeah.
With the hip.
Hip
and the slick.
Perfect.
Hip. And the slits.
You are going to be beautiful.
Okay, so I'm going to teach you the new new ballet that I just invented. And I saw you, and I really like your moves.
Beautiful. I think this is great. You're going to be the best ballet coach I've had since I started this morning.
Yeah. So your hips, your moves, your hair moves, that's going to be perfect for the new ballet.
Excellent. So do you want me to just like do it in addition, or do you want to show me some new moves?
Just maybe add a little twirl.
Okay. Like that.
Yes.
So how are you enjoying this birthday party?
You throw the most amazing birthday parties ever. I can't believe you actually got Cher to come and sing.
I know. I just love Cher.
She's the best. And you clearly have all the connections, so I can't wait to think who you're going to bring out next after Cher.
Well, you know, my family can't tell, you know, we have a lot of connections. Last name Spielberg, so I'm lining up to sort of come to this birthday party, get the connections.
That name sounds sort of familiar.
Yes.
Yeah, so what are you thinking then? Are you thinking like Britney Spears, or are you gonna have like the president?
Okay, so this is a really like exclusive sort of person. She has a really busy schedule, but she squeezed us in. Kellyanne Conway.
Amazing.
She's a secret.
That's our show.
praying mantis, and we will just ask the audience for a suggestion to get started.
Ambition.
Boot tape. Toaster. There is one thing you should know about breakfast, and that's I'm not eating it. No matter what. I have half a cup decaf coffee, and that is enough to get me right ready to start my day. If you put a bagel near me, I'm going to gag. It's too early in the morning, and I do not want a bagel. Understand me? I don't want that many carbs that early in the day. And so if I come to, like, a pre-work get-together where people are like, oh, donuts, I'm like, excuse me. Do I look like the kind of person that's just going to eat, like, a strawberry-frosted Dunkin' Donuts donut at 7:15 a.m.? I don't think so. I really would rather... Like, not to be dramatic, like, I'm not dramatic. I don't want drama in my life. That's why I don't hang out with, like, Stephanie anymore. Because, like, seriously, I don't need that drama. But I would rather die.
I would rather die than hang out with Stephanie ever again. Let me tell you about what she did that time when she did invite me to pre-work donuts. She not only invited me, but then had the nerve to spike my coffee with donuts. You're probably like, wait, how does that even happen? And I'm like, drinking my coffee, and I'm like, ooh, this tastes like weird. Is this a donut in here? And she's like, yeah, I ground the donuts and put them in your coffee, and figured you wouldn't notice. And I said, that's enough. We can never be friends. Ever, ever, ever again. And then she goes, and she's calling my phone and blowing me up, and I'm like, ignore, ignore.
And so she's blowing my phone up, and I'm like, ignore, ignore, we were just together last night. I don't need to see you again. I'm having breakfast with the people at work. I'm done. I got mine, you didn't get yours, sorry. Right? That's what I'm saying. Stephanie, man, she's always blowing my phone up. I'm calling, she's calling, I'm like, it's just too much work. So yeah, breakfast? No, 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 no. Just coffee and a donut. Early in the morning, by yourself, alone. That's the way to have it. I'm out of here.
Hey.
Hey.
You know, you've been my doctor for a really long time, and really frustrating.
I'm glad.
But this anxiety has been just bad. I have a presentation at work tomorrow, and I'm just, can you give me something?
Tell me a little more about your symptoms. Okay, you told me a couple things you've told me about.
We see them at Planned Parenthood.
you told me about your promiscuity.
Yes, okay. I see the judgment in your eye. I see the judgment,
no,
but
no,
I,
no.
Look, I just need you to give me something. You gave me, last time you gave me Xanax, and then you gave me Clonopin, right? Then you gave me, Sertraline, then you gave me, you gave me all these pills, and it's not working. I need something else.
Is this a plant that you wanted a huge box of condoms for?
Confidentiality?
I don't think we need to write a prescription for anything else today.
I don't want a prescription. I want you to give me something.
Hey, John. So you have this, I heard you're the guy that just emailed some content. You got some freelance for me, maybe?
Yeah, but who told you that?
Words on the street. You know, everybody's talking about her from. I heard from Keisha, I heard from Pam, I heard from, Jason. I heard from quite a few people that you're the guy to see for some condoms. Now, I know you use them a lot, but you can probably spare me if you have this giant box at home.
Sure.
So
yeah.
You got me on the hookup?
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, let me hook you up.
Cool. Yeah, let's go back to the house. We'll get some condoms and.
I'm getting something to buy from you.
I think we're going back to the house. You got a whole box, right?
Yeah, two more, please. I'm gonna have another drink, right?
Yeah.
It's been a long day at work.
It has been the longest day.
Yeah, I know, right? Yeah, double. Yeah, double. Yeah, you do a really good job. Since you've been here, I'm really, really glad that you've helped us out, and you've been a great intern. It's really worked out well. Here's to that. Cheers. Woo! Yeah, so manager's really hard on you, and I don't really like it. Things hard on me.
I don't like it either. I don't
really
get it.
Right, yeah, I don't either. We should talk more about that.
Why are you touching me?
I'm sorry, I didn't notice. I feel like
weird things like that keep happening in the office.
Yeah.
Like the manager is like yelling at me all the time, and you're like being weird and like touching me and buying these double shots.
Well, I'm trying to make you feel comfortable at work. You know, it's a new job for you, and I'm kind of like the welcome wagon sort of.
Yeah, but Jason, like, I'm like, at first I was like, cool, you're gonna buy me drinks, but I'm not even like 21 yet.
No, she's fine. She's fine.
Yeah, I mean, it's weird. Like, if one of us gets arrested, it would be you, because like.
Don't get arrested. So it's all good. Take it easy on the drink there. Then I won't let anybody arrested. Arrested's not good. So, yeah, let's have this drink. Cheers. Here's to another good year.
Just get your name.
see that they're in a cooking class in the city.
We get hotter, fluffier, and when we go on that show, I'm gonna tear your ass up. How many pancakes I've got already?
You've always been jealous of me.
I'm not jealous.
Yeah,
I'm a better cook.
Grandma told me you were jealous.
Just because Grandma gave you the recipe doesn't mean she likes you more.
Grandma also let me sleep in a bed.
Contestants, 5 minutes left before you must present your pancakes.
I've got whipped cream for mine. Shh. What do you have?
Don't worry about what I have.
What do you have? What do you? You using that?
Oh, let's see here. Oh, these pancakes look marvelous. There's a lot of alcohol in this building. I don't know, like, what, like, whose idea that was. What's your concern? My concern is, like, when I'm trying to do a spreadsheet about, like which hospitals should get funding, it's really distracting when people are getting shot.
Hey guys, it's tequila too.
I'm not even 11.
like this, I don't...
Shots. Let's go. Let's go home. You're fine. I'll help you walk.
And that's our show.
Thinking when he said we were celebrating our anniversary.
Only the best for you. This here isn't just any moon bounce. This here is a Winston 5000.
He said that we were going to be doing something out of this world. I was thinking, like, maybe, I don't know, a trip, like, out of our backyard.
Well, babe, see, Winston is named after the famous satellite that was launched in mid-80s.
You know how I feel about the 80s.
Well, I know it's a love-hate relationship. Love everything except the hair.
Is this it, then, for our anniversary? Are we going to do something afterwards?
Well, I mean, sure, we could do something else, you know. Maybe get some takeout, some Chinese.
Chinese takeout and a moon bounce for the anniversary?
I know!
Jesus Christ, Jane! I thought your marriage was doing that poorly.
Down, and he's like, hey,
you
wanna come bounce with me? Really?
I mean,
a moon bounce?
Oh.
10 years?
Did you at least like have sex in it or something?
Tell me you did, right?
Or is that still an issue for him? A little bit.
I mean, I tell you about all my dating nonsense. I mean, you're lucky.
You've got to fill me in. I need some good news.
I mean, let me tell you, it's just like, I mean, it's terrible out there. All these people are just assholes. And not even rich ones. At least if they're rich or old and rich, ideally, then they'll die.
Right?
You got that going for you. I mean, good credit score will really go a long way. The rest of it doesn't so long.
You're lucky. You're lucky, Jane.
Really? You are. You really should count your blessings. You know? But if you think that it's not going to work out, I mean, you could go on a date with me. They have these, like, group date things.
try that.
Could we maybe go on a group date? I could bring him along, and you could find something to go out with him.
That's a good idea. Hi, I'm here for the date.
Okay, I will let you guys do your thing.
All right. I'm so happy we swiped right.
Yeah, so it was Phil, right?
Phil, yes.
Yes. So, my recollection was that you said you were a small business owner. Could you fill me in on what that is?
Yes, I pick up animal poop.
Okay.
Far more complex than anything you've ever heard of. Don't listen to the stories. It is hard. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, and it pays really great, about $5 an hour, which is top of the line.
Okay. So what do you do with the poop after you pick it up? Like,
I put it in the trash can.
Okay.
Did you think that I should do something different with the food?
Well, I don't know. I just thought, like, maybe, you know, like, composting seems to be a girl. I don't want to take any of your business, though. I mean, I don't
like it. She actually tried to give me advice, and I stopped. No, I can't do that.
Okay, so do you do these dates a lot, then?
Well, I mean, you have to define a lot, right? I mean, for me, I think that once every day is not a lot, right? That feels normal and good to me.
Okay, well, I mean, you chose laundromat as our date. Choice. So I don't know. I like to make sure my women aren't dated.
Okay. Right?
Then I was a bad pick.
So, are you a poor asshole or a rich asshole? I'm not sure if I'm rich or poor. So, are you gonna, like, do the yoga? This is like a poor asshole yoga class.
Does say poor asshole,
does it?
Yeah,
right.
It's not
just this isn't really what I thought we were going to be doing. I don't know why you don't want to go to the laundromat. That's where all the girls like to go. You seem a little jaded. Yeah, but seriously, really, like when you're on these dating sites, how do you describe yourself? Are you a rich asshole or a poor asshole? Again, it's important. Okay, I think you're getting tied into the word asshole too much. Doesn't make much sense to me. We're doing child's pose now. Okay, well, I'm gonna, like this. You look great that way. Yeah, this is great. So, do you go on a lot of dates? The only people that I date are in this yoga class. Because they've got to be a poor asshole and they've got to be into yoga. Well, I can see because they're all winking at you. They like what they see. Okay, I'll keep trying. Is this all we're doing all night?
Mary, you said yes to my date, but at least we know that this is for me. I'm not an asshole. To date, my profiles, as you can see, have been very fastidious about reporting on how nice I am.
First of all, stop. What does fastidious mean? Okay, this is. You probably just want to sit down. Because this is a yoga class, so you don't spend a lot of time standing. Do you sleep?
Sort of.
I sleep on
sort
the floor.
Of.
Do you sleep upside down?
No. On top of things, if we're talking.
Okay, well, I sleep on the floor, and sometimes I'll sleep upside down. All of this is in my profile. It's like you're trying to...
So nice to be out on a
That's totally believe you.
I'm really not.
I mean, you pick this awesome, no assholes allowed yoga class.
Lovely.
Yeah.
Notice how quiet it is.
I know. I'm just wondering, like, why are we the only people here?
It's a vetting process, unfortunately.
Wow. You've got a taste. I like that.
Thanks, Jane. You do this. So, on your profile, it did say you were fastidious.
I'm so fastidious, I know what that word means.
Excellent.
My whole vocabulary is
fastidious. Such trouble meaning fastidious.
Fastidiousness is, I mean, it's my jam. None of that.
No white furniture.
No, furniture's it's just the right amount of clean.
Is it?
Yeah, it's slightly used.
So, what are you looking for in a relationship?
Basically, just somebody who is at peace with us. I'm just worried that, you know, with all this talk of fastidiousness and other kind of long words, I might not. Finally, there's somebody else here.
Yes, I'm sorry, I don't want to rush you.
That's okay.
The New Spirit Church is going to be taking place here pretty soon.
Oh,
are you part of the New Spirit Church?
Yes, I'm ready to say.
I'm sorry. This is not what I signed up for.
I'm burning sage because I feel there's a remnants of assholes.
Well, the sage is working. The sage is really clearing out all the bad vibes that date you just split on me left me with.
Exactly. I told you, you must stay within the church to find your mate.
Oh, I'm never leaving the New Spirit Church. I promise you, Lord Spiritual Master.
Listen to you. Now, remember the nice young lady that you met the last time?
Oh, yes. Yes. She left too. She's not big into churches where there's only two members.
Well, you know that she had a sense about you. She knew that she had to look for other doors, other windows, and that we must make a pathway for other assholes to come in, and then we need to cleanse them.
Yes, cleansing assholes is what the New Spirit Church is all about.
I know, I see your aura changing from brown to yellow.
I feel more yellow.
I start to go brighter. This way we can go out and meet more people. It won't be hard because assholes are not hard to find.
Presentation skills at work, so I have to go to this new age.
Oh, God.
Sorry, I'm here. Oops. Hi. I have a reservation for Tiffany at 5 p.m.
Yes, that would be me. Yes, I need to cleanse you. You obviously are a very dark brown. Your aura needs to be changed.
I have to. I'm so sorry. I have to go.
Yes, we need to remove that. That thing is vibrates with negativity.
Anyway, I'm here. They told me I was too aggressive at work with my presentations, PowerPoint and all. So I've just come to, I guess, ease up a little bit.
Yes. What are you? You came to the right place. This is sage. You need to breathe in.
Oh, very, very strong, wafty smell.
It is supposed to take out all the negativity in the Lord knows.
A lot. I don't know.
Becky at a birthday party the other day. I know you love Becky, of course, right? Yeah. Yes, yes.
By the way, you seem so much more relaxed.
Thank you.
The company policy has been really helpful with these extracurricular classes that we've approved. But anyway, back to Becky.
Yeah.
She was having a birthday party, and let me tell you, it was amazing. We got this moon balance clowns, ponies, everything. But let me tell you.
I didn't get an invite.
Well, you are just an employee here.
Isn't Becky also an employee here?
Well, Becky, my daughter, yes, we do nepotism. She is 12, but I mean, if Trump can do it, I can do it. It's all about it. It's the American way now. It makes sense. It makes sense. But you, unfortunately, you went too far with the cleansing. You've kind of gone to the other end. You're too relaxed now.
What do you mean? Just because I'm wearing flip-flops and
that's
Tommy Bahama shirt doesn't mean I'm relaxed.
I think that exactly. You've taken casual Friday too far.
It's casual Friday.
Yes, but you've taken it too far. I mean, at least this week you wore pants. Last week.
I got air and I. You feel a little more free.
Well.
Sage!
This is why. That's the problem, the sage. Yes, the sage. There's been complaints.
Just as I burn it in my office?
Yes, that's specifically the complaint. That's exactly the problem.
The problem with burning a little sage in the office?
We do
and
have.
Around,
right.
You know, like, you know,
well, the sprinkler system?
It goes off, it's nice.
I'm going to go back to the point of being too relaxed. Yes.
Tom.
Yeah, right. Yeah. And then when you're yelling, burning man!
It's fun, right? It's like a surprise!
It is.
Yes.
Yeah, Becky was saying that at her corporate meeting, yeah. Such a wise girl.
You really just get a lot from your daughter.
Hey, I wanted to thank you for letting me have the mood balance for the week.
did it work? I specifically, my wife says for our anniversary, it was like, boom bounce, Chinese food. We were like, Janice loves it.
Hey, honestly, it could have gone a little bit better. Unfortunately, the pills didn't work.
Really? That's how we conceived little Becky. I mean, it was on a moon bounce.
I know. Moon bounce thinking the kids, and then, you know, bam, 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 we got one of our own.
It didn't work.
No. That surprises me.
Did you dress up like a clown?
No.
That's